Hey, what's going on, beautiful brothers and sisters? This is Kyra Henderson here, interpreter of African American history and also motivational and speaker. One of the things I want to do right now is just thank each and every last one of you all for tuning in. It is the first day of Black History Month. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all so much again for tuning in. Now, today being February 1st, 2020, is an important day because 60 years ago today, the first sit-in took place in Greensboro, North Carolina. A man by the name of Reverend James Lawson, who is 90 years old now, but he was a much younger man back in the day. He's having these different sit-in trainings in the city of Nashville. In Nashville, Tennessee, as he's having these sit-in trainings, students will go in and they have to prove to be nonviolent no matter what, because if you could not prove to be nonviolent, you could not participate in these actual sit-in protests. But the first one does take place February 1st, 1960, with four North Carolina A&T college students. They went in and asked to be served, and of course they wouldn't be served. But even though they would not be served, this was not going to stop them. They came back a few days later with other students with them. And by day six of this sit-in protest, students from all over the South, they were participating in actual sit-in protests, over 1,400 of them. They would go in and ask to be served and wouldn't be served, but they would face other things more brutal. Hot, fresh brew coffee poured in their heads, with food being thrown at them. Not to mention also being beaten and even slapped, these young ladies would be. And through all that brutality, they did absolutely nothing back in return. Sit-ins that are popping up everywhere. Students in Mississippi, whether it's in Mississippi or Georgia, North Carolina, no matter where it is, they are having these sit-in protests. The city of Nashville has something to be most proud of because a beautiful young lady by the name of Diane Nash led a student walk out there and confronted Mayor Ben West and asked him the question of moral rights and asked him, do you feel that the lunch counter should be desegregated here in Nashville, Tennessee? And he agreed with her. And a few weeks later, they were the first city in the South to successfully desegregate their lunch counters. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks to these beautiful, brave young men, women, and children, what happens is a movement is going to be born about 5 years prior to this with the Montgomery bus boycott. But to these young people, 16, 17, 18-year-old college students, are going to give us our first birth of nonviolent resistance. And they wanted to prove that nonviolent resistance actually created a violent response. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for tuning in for the first day of Black History Month. And I hope that you all will come back tomorrow, because we're going to turn up with all these beautiful heroines and all these heroes of the civil rights movement. Thank you all so much, ladies and gentlemen. Peace be unto you. And I thank you all so much for helping me celebrate a month in a time that is so dear to me. Ladies and gentlemen, may walk so we can run. You all enjoy the rest of your evening, and I'll see you all tomorrow again around this time.